Globally, more than 570 million households farm small plots of land to earn income, yet many of these farmers live in poverty. One major barrier for smallholder farmers is the lack of access to actionable information they can use to adopt improved farming practices and make more informed management decisions. Evidence from randomized evaluations in Kenya and India demonstrated how mobile phones could be a much more cost-effective and efficient way to deliver the personalized information farmers needed to increase their yields and to optimize their practices.
Evidence-based policymaking is tremendously important in all fields, but perhaps especially in agriculture. And so to do that, we felt it was necessary to build an organization that systematically conducted RCTs, A/B tests, and data collection in a variety of settings to build an evidence base about what works and what doesn't work.
Building on this evidence, in 2016, an organization called Precision Agriculture for Development, PAD, was established as a nonprofit with a mission to support smallholder farmers in low and middle income countries.
So we found intriguing results that extremely low cost information could change farmer behavior and improve farmer outcomes. But we didn't want them to just those results to just sit as academic papers forever. So Michael Kramer and I and Dan Bjorkegren and Heiner Baumann got together and founded PAD with the mission of refining, developing, and delivering high-quality agricultural advice to 100 million smallholder farmers worldwide. J-PAL and IPA have been really important partners as PAD has grown, and we work with them closely, utilizing their expertise in conducting RCTs. They've played a really important role, for example, in connecting to us with the government of Odisha, where we're currently working with them to serve over a million farmers.
We use mobile phone-based extension because it's low cost, it's scalable, and the ability to tailor information to each individual's crop conditions, you know, where they live, what language they speak, what kind of technology they're comfortable with, is what makes this model impactful and exciting.
Since its launch in 2016, PAD has rapidly expanded into new geographies and widened their scope of research.
PAD's model of information delivery is not specific to agriculture extension. And there's so much information out there from which poor people could benefit, but all kinds of frictions in systems and in governments and markets make it very difficult for them to access that information. So I think PAD's role will continue to be exploring and finding new ways of reducing these barriers across agricultural value chains and also beyond agriculture.
PAD's experience demonstrates the value of randomized evaluations to launch more effective approaches to reducing poverty on a global scale.
Another benefit of conducting RCTs is that it gets the researchers really close to the problem and really close to the farmers. We spend time in the field, our staff spends time in the field, and you really understand the constraints and optimizations and even the hopes and dreams of the farmers you're working with. And I think all of that also helps us as an organization credibly convey our findings to policymakers.
PAD has served 3.56 million farmers across 9 countries in Africa and South Asia in collaboration with 27 partners. In 2020, the nonprofit assessment group GiveWell identified PAD as a standout charity, in part due to their commitment to ongoing research and transparency. In 2021, PAD was renamed Precision Development, or PXD, to reflect their growing scope of research and policy impact. PXD continues to experiment, iterate, and gather evidence on impact to improve service delivery and support people living in extreme poverty.